we started journalism at a time when Future Shock was being written and published, about which she mentioned. We started journalism at that time, and if you see, or if Alvin Toffler himself confesses, he'll find that what was supposed to be a future shock today is not even a minor vibration as to what we experience in the media. It is like dinosaurs using the WhatsApp and on Android. And actually, the media has so transformed that previously it used to be called simple press. It used to be known as freedom of the press. Nobody used the term media. The media term came when press began to get glamorized. Media is a glamorous term. Press is not a glamorous term. Press is on its way out. Most of the people, most of the futurists say that there will be no newspaper. London Economist headlined cover story that there will be the last newspaper published in something like 2033 or 2034. There will be no newspaper in print form. So the newspapers will be in electronic form, on iPad and everywhere. And what has happened is, nowadays, people buy newspapers. They don't read. What they read is Twitter. Now, Twitter is 140 letters, including the gaps. Now, unfortunately, if the thinking is reduced to 140 letters, what happens, we are seeing around. And that's why every time you have to explain to the young students, but you are so bright that you don't have to be explained and taught, that you are entering the world of media, actually the real world, not only of media, is so exciting and frustrating at the same time that you don't know which to choose, the excitement part of it or frustration part of it. Journalists go through both the phases of frustration and excitement. Frustration when you see the actual reality, not only as shown in the film Slumdog Millionaire, but actually if you go to Annawadi, which is not very far from here, if you go there in the morning and come back in the evening, and if you are not totally disgusted with life, I'm not saying India, I'm not saying Mumbai, I'm not saying Annawadi, if you don't get disgusted with life, it will be surprising. At the same time, if your attitude towards life is positive, you will feel after going there, this must change. And you'll work for change because things have changed. When I was in school, or when many of your parents were in school, the life was even more miserable than it is today. And it has improved. There were not even 1 crore people in the middle class when we became free. Today there are something like 40 crore people in the middle class. And these 40 crore people in the middle class apart, there are something like 80 crore mobile phones in the country of 130 crores. So if mobile phones, which started only actually 15, 16 years ago, many of you may not remember, almost till 1998, the price for each call was something like 18 rupees. Even to receive call was 9 rupees. There was nothing like SMS initially. Then came SMS, then came Orkut, then came, you know, today we are up to WhatsApp. And therefore, with all that revolution in the technological aspect of media, why should anybody read newspapers? Or why should anybody, I am told, according to the opinion surveys and the viewership surveys, that the news channels are watched the least. Entertainment channels are watched the most. Thankfully, the other superstitious channels which go in the name of religion are not watched as many. But point is, news channels are not watched as by large number as one may think. And therefore, you are entering the media, not only of news media. And now our anchor persons have reduced the entire news medium, particularly the panel discussions, as another form of entertainment. So all the people who participate on the panels shout at each other to make those 40 minutes more interesting than actually they could have been. Because the subject is of a very minimal value, but the importance that the panel thinks it has is so huge that it is going to determine the future not only of the nation but of the world. Once the panel is out, the world has changed because the panelists have given their wisdom how to change the world. And the panelists advise everybody, from Barack Obama to Dr. Manmohan Singh to Narendra Modi to everybody. panelists advise everybody. I am sure even after 16th May, panelists will continue to advise how to form the government. Because that is going to be the main challenge. Main challenge because we have to, and particularly you have to recognize that we have to preserve, as journalists, as media persons, as humans, that we have to preserve the idea of India. And that idea of India is a fantastic idea, just as Ms. Lawson mentioned. Country with 5,000 castes, 25,000 subcastes, something like 30,000-40,000 community caste religious syndromes. There is a book, or there is actually series of volumes published by Anthropological Survey of India. Something like 76 volumes have been published. And that shows, that throws a light on what India is. A person in Tamil Nadu's village is a complete foreigner when he is in a Punjab village. Both are perhaps literate, both are perhaps doctorate, and still they won't be able to talk to each other. And yet this country has survived as a democracy for the last 66 years is the greatest achievement. Remember, this democracy will have no meaning if there is no freedom of the press. And that freedom of the press is what you have to cherish and you have to promote. And let me tell you, it is not going to be an easy task in future to protect, preserve and promote freedom of the press, that is freedom of the media, that is to also promote human rights. You will require courage, you will require curiosity, you will require mainly concern for the humans to be a good journalist, to be a good Indian. It is a challenge. I am sure all of you will take that challenge and live. Thank you very much.